woman in command. They're working now, but they're thinking how they love
two scoops.
And Golden Flakes a brand.
Two scoops.
They're turning back again for two scoops of plump, juicy raisins
in Kellogg's Raisin Brand.
Two scoops.
Go for more at Sears.
Now you can have the confidence of a diehard battery in every vehicle you own. Save 15 to 25% on diehards for cars, trucks, and RVs. Save 40% on Sears' new Steady Rider gas charge shocks, now $14.99 each. And get Sears' exclusive new SuperGuard response radio, as low as $34.99 each. At Sears, we install confidence, day and night.
There's more for your life at Sears.
The Games of the 23rd Olympiad. Brought to you by 20th Century Fox, presenting Revenge of the Nerds and Dreamscape. IBM typewriters. No matter how you look at typing, wear your type. Miller High Life, the exclusive sponsor of the Olympic Training Centers. Welcome to Miller Time. And Levi Strauss & Company, official outfitter of the U.S. Olympic team.
All right, we're standing by, remember, for two more events in the decathlon. You'll be seeing that coverage live. Daley Thompson not only going for his second gold medal in a row, but also going for a world record. He is ahead of the world record pace at this point. So we're standing by for that. That'll be coming up. A lot more action out at the Coliseum and track and field. Right now, we're going to return to the diving and Jack Whitaker.
Here are the standings after six dives out of eight. And Zhou Jinghong of China still leads. Chen Shaoxia is second. Michelle Mitchell of the United States is third. But now, here is Chen Shaoxia.
Back 1.5 somersault with 2.5 twist. She has done this dive in the past for tens. I don't know if there was anything wrong with that dive.
Maybe a 10. This crowd loves it.
It may very well be.
The girl with the bandaged wrists.
I think we should just sit here and appreciate this. Oh, I did see a little break in the knees coming off the tower.
But she really has a rip here going
yeah,
in.
Yeah, you can...
Look at that.
You can hear the sound going in the water of the rip.
And the boos there, they thought a 10 was there, but a couple of 9s. That's Chen Shaoxia. Let's meet her up close and personal.
China's Great Wall is a 2,000-year-old monument to man's craving for security and his willingness to make sacrifices to attain it. It is a symbol of this country, so rich in human resource, so troubled in finding how to use it. In the early morning haze of Beijing, the skyline's image is softened and diffused by the dust that blows in from the Gobi Desert, just the other side of the Great Wall. Nothing, it would seem, here is sharp, well-defined. Impressions count, not definitions. When the Chinese women's diving team begins calisthenics at 6:30 a.m., what radiates is a spirit, a calm acceptance of the need to punish the body in order to satisfy the ambition. For Chen Shaoxia, it's a natural extension of a spirit that she found a long time ago.
I guess I love diving because I always loved the water ever since I was a kid. So naturally, I got into diving.
On a day off, one of her favorite places is a 15th century park called the Temple of Heaven. She strolls here with a friend and advisor from the China Sports Federation, Kanling Fan, who helps her relax when things get too tense. She's 22. She's been diving competitively since she was 9. One of the special features of the park is a circular wall around what's called the Imperial Vault of Heaven. Here, with fellow diver Li Hongping, she tries out the remarkable symmetry of the walls. Here, two people on different sides of the courtyard can whisper and yet be heard distinctly.
Hey,
You must understand that Chin Chow Chai is someone who cares about being heard clearly. She's not afraid to voice an opinion, especially when it concerns her training. She was born in Canton in the South, and there began her career. They tell the story that when she stalked into the special sports school to apply for admission to diving classes, the coach asked if she'd dare dive into the pool right next to him. She said sure, and did. And that's when the coach found out two things: that she was utterly fearless, and that she could not swim, at least in deep water. But that was a long time ago. Since those days, she's come north to Beijing to train, and now east, far east, to Los Angeles, to compete on her country's first Olympic team in more than 30 years.
All right, we're back here at the diving competition for the women on 10-meter platform. This is the seventh out of eight in the preliminaries, and we're looking now at Wendy Weiland of the United States. She's the current Wendy world champion, sixth after six dives. And she's going to do a back 2.5 somersaults in a pike position, 2.9 degree of difficulty.
This is one of those difficult dives that Wendy has a little bit of anxiety about. Sometimes she jumps a little bit too far away from the tower and has trouble going in vertically on the entry. Did a real nice job on that. She did jump out just a little bit, but she's able to control it by looking back early enough. Let's see. She bends down. See her shoulders go back there. A little bit too far. She over-rotates somewhat on the entry, but not too bad for Wendy.
And there are her marks, 50.46 for Wendy Weiland. Well, you just met Chen Xiaosha of China. Here is the other Chinese woman diver here in this competition, Zhou Qinghong, who is first after six dives.
Qinghong, 305C, a reverse
two. Zhou is doing a reverse 2.5 somersault tuck, 2.7. She is just a master at this dive. And the reason is because she's learned how to come out of these somersaults looking at the water with her chin in and then look back to control the entry. She went over a little bit, but she was very clean on the entry, so I think she'll be rewarded for that. Now we're watching super slow motion that she bends forward a little bit right there on the tower. You see her kick and rotate just a little bit past vertical. She still receives seven, so that's not bad.
So there are her marks.